Thank you very much. Dear Chairman and dear colleagues, it is my pleasure to be here to talk about the Pectus surgery. I'd like to share my experience and my idea with you. And this is the subject is, when should Pectus be corrected? It is very difficult to answer. But I'd like to, what I, in my window, how I see in this question. And I have no conflict of interest. You know, the current treatment is vacuum bell is recently more popular, and surgical nasal operation and ravage operation. Still, we are doing ravage operation. In the literature, we see this type of the article, sudden cardiac arrest in a young patient with severe pectus excavatum. This is from India. Last year they published, but it is very seldom. I mean, not too much, just few articles we can see in this type of the published article. This patient, 19 years old, and they couldn't find any reason apart from the pectus excavatum, and they did the ravage surgery for this patient. And and the other article from the Canada, last year they published, pectus excavatum and right ventricular compression in a young athlete with syncope. This patient, 37 years old, and she also underwent two previous syncope, and then they couldn't find anything, any other reason. The patient has a pectus excavatum deep, and then they advised the surgery, but not applied that time. This is the another article from the Canada. Julia and his colleagues, longer term effect of close repair of pectus excavatum on cardiopulmonary status. In this article, they started with 217 patients and then drop out and finally finish 60 patients. This means it is very difficult, long prospective study in this pectus patient. And then there is conclusion. In summary, the result of this study show a modest improvement in pulmonary function and exercise testing in moderate to severe pectus defect when repaired with the NAS procedure. Also, statistically not significant in this study. And this is the big review I have seen in the published review from the United States down. She is a good surgeon about the pectus surgery. She reviewed about more than 30 papers, published papers, 32, I think, 9 papers from published about the pulmonary function test, 9 papers about cardiac status, and 19 papers, 14 papers cardiopulmonary status. But this is the conclusion. It is very difficult collect together because of different parameters they have. For example, about the echocardiography. Half of the author did transthoracic echocardiography in the pectus patient. Half of the author did the transesophageal echocardiography. This means it is very difficult to get the same result with the transthoracic echocardiography and from the transesophageal echocardiography. That's why the conclusion, continued effort to quantify physiologic change in cardiopulmonary performance after pectus excavatum repair need to occur with adequately powered study and consistent methodology. Surgical correction when and what is our indication? Patient must be older than 12 years old, Haller index more than 3.25, pulmonary function must be restrictive and obstructive. Cardiological compression, displacement, murmurs, or conducting anomaly must be the patient. And symptomatic deformity like dyspnea, tachycardia, exercise intolerance, and previously failed repair, and psychosocial problems. And we should build a scoring system, and including the Haller Index, it is called also Pectus Severity Index, cardiac status, pulmonary status, comorbidities, symptoms, effort capacity, and psychosocial status. And this is my experience in 14 years. I have operated more than 1,000 pectus excavatum cases in 14 years, median age 19, and 12% female and the others male, and mostly symmetric, 80%, and 20% asymmetric. And I insert more than 1,300 bar, and 66% one bar, and 32% two bar, and 1.5% three bar. Sorry. Can I get next slide? Yeah. In our case, we did 2 years follow-up study in the prospective study, and we have seen we asked NAS questionnaire for patient and NAS questionnaire for parents. You see here preoperatively 31, and then increase after the operation, and also for the parents increase. This means improved quality of life for NAS operation in our patient. And also social appearance anxiety scale, you see here decrease, and role limitation due to the physical health and also increase. This means decreased social anxiety and better physical health. I'm sorry. Yeah. And I'd like to share my article from How Pulmonary Function Change After Pectus Excavatum Correction Surgery. We published 2015. And conclusion, just I will give 80 patients we put in this study. And conclusion, minimally invasive pectus excavatum repair has a positive impact on quality of life pectus excavatum patient, but a negative impact on forced vital capacity. Need more study. And the other, for the quality of life work in 88 patients. And conclusion, minimally invasive repair of pectus excavatum significantly improve the physical and psychosocial well-being of patient. Need more study. This is the last we published 2017. Even the excavatum and carinatum patient, psychosocial function in pediatric patient, conclusion, improve self-esteem and better social and academic skill. And this is another published article. And the result is post-operative satisfaction for this NAS operation from our patient. This is from the Hans Pilegaard. Hans Pilegaard in the Europe, he's a famous surgeon. He has done 1,700 NAS operation. And this is the result. This is the review for about the pectus surgery. And this result, that surgery for cosmetic reason is a good indication. And because study show significant improvement in quality of life after surgical correction. What is the take-home message? And progressive deformity plus cardiorespiratory symptoms like arrhythmia or mitral valve prolapse, and pectus severity index of more than 3.25 or more, cardiac compression or displacement,
abnormal pulmonary function study, restrictive or obstructive. If you will decide surgical correction, at least two of four criteria must be the patient inpatient. And this means surgical indication, you can find 5% or less physiological change in the patient. And mostly 95% of cosmetic reason you have to operate your patient and need more long-term study. Thank you very much for your patience.